Big shout to everybody that got to attend the 2020 Sturgis bike rally. And I just want to say I am proud to represent the greatest culture in the world. And we talk about how them Antifa boys get sent home by MC Culture. And we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. No, yeah, we ghosting, baby. Big shout to the ghosts and the ghost sets. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost. I'm your host for the evening. And today we're going to talk about it. Sturgis 2020, the Coliseum of MC culture, of biker motorcycle culture, the place where politics get put to the side and everybody just has a good time. And still, the parasites show up with their signs trying to put down God and America. And we'll get into what I mean by that. But the first thing I want you to do, like we always do on this channel, is to hit me with that pound ghosting. And that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on twos, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. Shout to all my new subscribers. Welcome to the row. Shout to everybody that was out at the Sturgis rally representing Demons Row clothing. Get your Demons Row clothing now. I'm going to be posting those pictures up. It's amazing the reach that we have. This is a great culture, and I am proud to represent it. Follow the Sos the Ghost page. We got a lot coming on that, and let's just get right into it. No other segments. This is a special. We're going to talk about Sturgis 2020, how the MCs, how the bikers, whatever you consider yourself, whatever you call yourself. I've been saying this for a minute. The MCs, the one percenters, the bikers, the three percenters, anybody that sits on twos or loves this country. I said it was going to be on our culture to stand tall against this oppression, and oppression at its finest, because as something that we hold so dear as the Sturgis rally, a time where we put all the politics and all the bullshit to the side and just ride and have a good time. What this culture is about, these parasites come along and want to make it political. They want to come to our events and think that they're going to do the same things that they do all over the country and get away with it. And guess what? MC Culture said, hell no, take your ass home. And this is sad. It's becoming the new normal. We have to see protest signs everywhere we go now. Like, you can't have a good time anymore without this oppression, anti-American bullshit put in your face. Antifa showing up with their signs, and you could see how many enemy flags are on American soil right now. I mean, enemy flags. The signs saying, wear your mask. Oppression. Like, you don't have a right to go outside without a mask on. That's what they want you to believe. And I'm going to get censored now because I say that. And then the people that just post up the drama, they're going to get a million views. But we already know that that's how this works. That's how this communist US is going right now, where freedom of speech is being attacked, full on attacked. But I don't care. On this channel, I'm going to continue to talk it. And I've been saying it for a long time. The one percenters, the three percenters, the bikers, we will be the ones to stand tall when it's crunch time. And I hate to say I told you so, but I told you so. My culture, the best culture in the world, told those parasites, go home, boys. Go home. Because this is not for you. And this is the point that we're getting to where there's no more having a good time. It's oppression with masks. They have the rainbow flag. What does that mean? It means destroy the family. Let's be real here. If you're on some rainbow shit, you can't have a family. You can't reproduce. And that's what they want. It's death to the family. It's no shade on anybody. What you do in your bed is your business. But that is an enemy flag because it's promoting the death of the family. The Antifa flag represents anti our country. And it looks, they always talking about anti-Nazi, but everything they do kind of has a Nazi feel to it. So I don't get where that comes from. And I'm glad that our culture sent them home. One of the Antifa dudes, big boy, they had to take him down. He kicked one of the bikers, and to save him from all the bikers, the wrath that would have put down upon him, the police protect them. And it's so funny how life works. And this is why I say, don't feed into these false narratives, because guess what? Those left wingers that are pushing this propaganda to defund the police, guess what? Who saved their ass at Sturgis? It was the police. The police saved their ass, and that's how it always is. It's always like that. So play chess. Don't let people make you think that you have to move a certain way. Look at the whole scope of the picture. And I want to commend everybody who represented for our culture. And big shout to whoever it was that was holding the sign with Donald Trump with the big machine gun. I actually used that picture on one of my first videos, which the quality is pretty bad because it was, you know, when I first started or whatever. So don't watch that video, but it's just funny to me. And big shout to him, because that was cool shit. And they stood right on the sign and represented, because Antifa had all their flags up, so they held that up and they held other signs up. And that was dope to me, and I respect that. You know what I mean? A lot of people speak down on Trump, but he's done more for the people that talk bad about him than any other president had. And let's just keep it real, that's the truth. Nobody wants to say it, because the left completely controls TV right now, so they have everybody thinking a certain way. But I'm not left or right. I just say the truth. This man has done a lot. He has done a lot of great things. And if he was wearing blue, trust me, this dude would be, they'd be talking about Mount Rushmore for him, for the stuff that he did. So don't get fooled by who owns the TV stations and that type of stuff, because you already know how that goes. But this is not about Trump right now. This is about our culture representing, kicking those cowards out of our event. It lets them know you're not accepted here, and you won't be, and we're not gonna let this fly. And I don't know if this is gonna spill over to Laconia now. I'm hearing that masks are gonna be mandatory. It's like they were there protesting because we were meeting up and we're supposed to be wearing masks and all that type of stuff. But if you are so keen on social distancing, why were you there? You know there was going to be thousands of bikers. Why are you there protesting and spreading your germs? Why are you doing that? Check into that. And whatever happened to treason? Does that exist anymore? This, like, treasonous behavior, anti-American behavior is so popular right now. Like, a phrase like make America great again is considered racist and hated, but the stuff that people promote is the most disgusting stuff in the world, and it gets pushed super hard. Hit that like button for me, y'all, because when I get too truthful, they try to suppress it. But when you hit the likes, it makes it, you know, it generates, you know, it tells the algorithm, yeah, push it, this is a good one. So hit that like button, share it, let people know the real deal behind what happened out there. Because a lot of times people will spin it and just be like, oh, the bikers were racist, they had Confederate flags, and they kicked Antifa out. Maybe Antifa's not that bad. Don't let them gas you up. This is the behind the scenes politics about what's going on in this country right now, and my culture will not stand for it. So share this video on your timeline. Let's make this number one on this topic, because these people just come with their camera and post stuff up, and then they bring light to that and not light to the real that we're talking about here in our culture. Thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.